County 911. What's the location of your emergency?
Covered Bridge in Smyrna. Apparently, there's somebody stuck in there again.
What bridge is that? The Covered Bridge?
Covered Bridge. Yes, on Concord.
Cobb County 911. What's the location of your emergency?
Yes, I'm in Smyrna, on Concord Road, right before the covered bridge. There's somebody who is stuck in the covered bridge.
I'm over here stuck on a bridge. It's Concord Road and Covered Bridge Road. I hit the sign. I didn't see there was a clearance sign.
We don't like to call it a nuisance, but occasionally, every time the beams are struck, we have to respond and put it back up. We have some really highly experienced crew that comes and restores the beam and puts it back up. If it wasn't for that beam, it would be substantial repairs to that bridge because it would be non-protected, and it would be thousands of dollars worth of damage, and that would encounter closing the road for days and weeks and maybe months. Right now, the crew has gotten so efficient and so good at putting that beam back up. You know, most of the time, it's less than an hour. We've got the road back open and the beam back up, and traffic is flowing freely again. But it's all, and I hate to say that it's from experience. This is the kind of experience you really don't want to have. But they've done well and trained and know what it takes to put the beam back up. They know the equipment, and they're very good at what they do. No matter what time of the day it is, we have 24/7 coverage, emergency coverage. That they always have the tools and the right equipment to put this back up.
It's been every month so far. One month it was twice in the same week, so that's kind of interesting, but it's been seven times since I've been here. We are actually dispatched to go out and do our bridge work, and at any moment, it's like being a first responder because of the fact that we have to drop everything we're doing and get over here and take care of the bridge as soon as possible, as soon as we get the call.
Numerous accidents, sometimes multiple ones, and as many as three or four over one weekend. That's the most I've seen. Others, it may be a month between times someone hits the barrier and or the bridge both. The accidents are from U-Haul trucks are one of the major things. Vans that are a little too high, and ignoring all the warnings. My wish for the bridge is that it remain where it is in perpetuity. That the other thing is that people say, well, the bridge is dangerous. The bridge is not dangerous. It's the drivers who ignore all the warning signs.